Okay, Sheriff. Here they are.
Tell the Marshal this ain't how we do things here. But I'll oblige him this once. All right. Let's see what we got. Come on. Well, let's get you in there then. I'm gonna need your details. Tell me everything except that you're innocent. I'd find that hard to believe. Quite a record we'll have on you. You're lucky you were caught, you know. The way the town feels about what happened, you were likely to be shot. It's a process, all right, but a necessary one. How you doing with that? Okay, then. Thank you.
It's all correct.
I'll take a photograph. Hold up your fingers. Stay there.
Jackson! Officer Jackson, move those prisoners! Officer Benton! Kitchen's East staff!
Officer Townsend, those rocks ain't gonna break themselves! What are you standing there for? Get moving! What are you looking at? Go on! Get moving!
You! You! You with the hammer! And you, you'll do. We need to perform a work detail out near Blackwater. Come on, get in. Open the gate. Come on, Milliken.
Tell you what, old Jameson is a wretched, sour old bastard, no mistake.
You lot stay calm in there.
You weren't saying nothing.
Well, you are now. Shut up. You know, my wife has acquired ideas significantly above her station. She's been reading too many goddamn books. Personally, I'm against education. Of women, I mean. And men, I guess. Unnecessary. Doesn't add much to the world. Education.
Good day, gentlemen.
Oh.
Don't do anything stupid. Nobody gets shot. Act like fools, and the pair of you will be dead within a minute. Now, what are your names?
Jenkins and Milliken.
Well, Mr. Jenkins and Mr. Milliken. Throw your guns to the ground and get on down here. That's it. Very glad to meet you. It's not worth being rash. You boys get paid a salary. You get that salary whether these people escape or not. Your wives presumably want you alive. Let them out. Now, please.
Okay. Okay.
You all run away. Aside from you. Try to stay out of trouble. This is a stroke of good fortune for all of you. Use it. Now, Mr. Jenkins and Mr. Milliken, be so kind as to quickly run away before somebody gets shot entirely unnecessarily. Go on, don't look back. Mr. Wendt, I believe it was $50 we agreed on.
It was.
Here's 50 each.
Each?
Yes. Now get out of here, both of you. My employer and I appreciate your professionalism.
All we did was stand there and look tough.
And you did it fantastically well. Good day, gentlemen. Now, ma'am, how about you pick up these guns and we move out? My mistress is waiting for us. Come along. And you better get on this horse. Not much of an animal, but they haven't got far to ride. Yeah, I waited on them moving you some weeks. I can wait a while longer. Ready? Wonderful. I hope you'll forgive the secrecy. My employer particularly values discretion.
My name is Mr. Horley, by the way.
6 months at Sisica Penitentiary, awaiting a hanging for a murder you did not commit. Must have felt a whole lot longer, my friend. You still seem strong, though. I mean, doesn't look like breaking all those rocks has left you entirely broken, in body or in spirit. I hope I am right about that. Rounding you folks up, those sham trials, they were a disgrace. Made a mockery of the rule of law. Still can't quite believe they got away with it. There's others convicted when you were. Came out breathing fire. Maybe you're like that too. Guess we'll see. Or maybe you just want to put it all behind you. Forget you were in there at all. That would be fine, of course. But you will listen to my mistress first. She spent a good sum getting you folks out. You owe her an audience, at least. You've been away for a while, so we'll help you get set up in the world. And if you want to accept our offer, you can. That's more than reasonable. And freedom out on the range can wait a few moments longer, can't it? Good. You're just up here. There's the camp. Hitch your horse.
I'll wait.
This way. She's anxious to meet you.
Madam, we're back.
Hello. Jessica Leclerc, how do you do? What did you tell her?
Nothing, as we discussed.
Thank you, Horley. I do hope we haven't inconvenienced you dreadfully. But seeing as you were due to be hanged in a week, I'm sure you don't object too strongly. I know you're innocent. Well, not perhaps exactly innocent, but not guilty of what you were accused. I know you and those who were with you that died were little more than patsies, and that you were set up by one of three men or a woman. Possibly by all of them. I can't be sure. But that is all I know so far.
And one of these people also made Mrs. Leclerc a widow.
And I will avenge my husband's death, so help me God. But I will not avenge it upon them who did not cause it, or caused it unwittingly. Anyway, I'm sure this is all a touch confusing and melodramatic. Where are my manners? Horley, please show our guests to their tent and give them some fresh clothes to put on.
Very good, madam.
Then serve us both a little refreshment.
Certainly, madam. This way. You'll find a change of clothes in there, alongside a few other items you might need, a lasso, a knife, and a lantern, I believe.
That looks more comfortable. Hawley?
Here, madam.
Your very good health. I suppose it beats dying, hmm?
Mrs. Leclerc's husband was murdered by one of his business partners.
And I intend to find out which one. Or rather, I intend for you to find out. And kill them. You're the only person I could possibly trust to do whatever it takes. Because you and your accomplices, you're the only other victims of their lies still alive. You see, you walked into the town at approximately the same time my husband was shot in the back, but by another gun, firing different bullets to those you possessed when you were arrested. These bullets, this was their mistake. You were rounded up and sentenced to death, all because you came to town and didn't talk too much and seemed like you were nasty. Anyway, here they are. The people who run Blackwater. Mr. Jeremiah Shaw, banker, real estate speculator, and crook. Mr. Amos Lansing, ranch owner, speculator, and crook. Mrs. Grace Lansing, his wife, society patroness, lover of the arts, crook, and my former best friend. Teddy Brown, her disgraced brother, outlaw, wanted man, and still in contact with them. All I ask of you is your help in finding out quite what happened.
Mrs. Leclerc would like to help you get back on your feet. Get back to work.
Whatever your work may be, I don't judge. You want to rob? Rob. You want to save innocent folk? Do that as well. But you need me just as much as I need you. I think we all understand each other.
I hope we do.
Good. I look forward to rewarding you for killing those who made me a widow. My husband was a true believer in this country and in the West. He was killed for greed. Foul greed when there's quite enough for everybody. I don't care what your scruples are as to killing. I will take the full burden of that sin upon my shoulders. Goodbye, for now. Then Hawley, go introduce her to nice Mr. Cripps.
I think you'll like Cripps well enough. He's long past his prime, of course, but he hasn't gone entirely crazy just yet. And he will help you better than most of his ilk. Cripps! Get up!
Hello, partner. Hawley.
This is your new boss.
Oh, pleased to meet you, partner. J.B. Cripps at your service.
We'll pay to get your camp established. Mrs. Leclerc is a generous benefactor.
And where are we headed?
Oh, and, madam, while Cripps is establishing your camp, perhaps you can go to the station and see the clerk, then head to see Clay Davies. He's a horse thief and, not a terribly nice one. Then meet Cripps back at your camp.
See you shortly, boss.
Good luck.
Get on to the station. It's not too far.
Get. Hello. You,
You must be a Horley's friend. He's one of us. He said you are also a discouraged creature. Now, I will be honest. I try not to talk too much to women. Let's leave that. Alden, that's me. But Horley insisted you was okay. I'm very discouraged, you see. Anyway, it's a pleasure to make your acquaintance. Sort of. I find your reticence charming. Real charming. I heard you might want to earn a little extra money. Well, some gentlemen have been robbing our stages, and they are not part of the club, if you catch my meaning. If you can make them go away, I'm sure they will have something of interest to you. They're up in tall trees. See what you can do, okay? Here, by the way, a catalog. The latest issue just came into this armpit from a land more civilized. And if things work out, well, my colleagues and I move around these stations as needed. And all of us are very discouraged. We will all help you with pertinent information, even if you are a lady. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Okay, that's enough, folks. Let's get back to work.
Okay. Okay. You're good. You're real good, friend. Here. Take this. It's a map. Just be kind. Don't kill me, please.
I win again. Did Horley send you, Pop? I'm Clay Davies. This is my brother.
Clive.
He don't talk. Maybe you two will get along better. Maybe not. Listen, I heard you wanted to earn some money. So, there's a gang of ne'er-do-wells. They are a bunch of degenerates, not good people. They're out a man's Anita Post with a bunch of horses they stole from me. Well, that's a lie, but they stole them off a fella I was gonna steal them off of. Maybe you could get them for me. You think you could do that for me, Pop? Oh, look. Here are your friends. Well, good. Meet me at the stable in Blackwater once you have the horse flesh. And I'll pay you good. Oh, and Pop, Horley wanted me to remind you any decent work you can find, take it. But just try to stay out of trouble. Oh, and once you give me those horses, well, after that, we'll talk again. Oh, I do so enjoy these conversations. I'm used to them on account of my brother. Let's go, Clive.
You're right. Get on the line here. Let's get you some.
well, well. Horley was right about you. Dead right. Ain't that dandy? Get that horse hidden away, Clive, and ready to move out as soon as we can. All right. Here's the money you earned. Now listen, Horley came by and gave me a message. He said to go see your friend Cripps up at your camp. Now listen to me for a second. Any other decent horses you find, we'll buy them. Just as soon as we are set up, okay? Nice meeting you. You know what? Hold on, boy. I call him boy because I'm older. 30 minutes, he went black. Let's give our friend here back the horse. It's yours. A sign of faith and future business. If you want to buy any extras or sundries for the animal, head inside. They've got a lot available. See you soon. Come on, Clive.
How do you get on with Clay Davies? Horrible little wretch, in my opinion. Pop this and pop that. I'd like to pop him a slime bucket. Anyway, I've got everything set up. Well, what we have so far, place is pretty nice. I think you did a good job for you. I'll earn my keep. When you get too old to fight, what choice have you got? It's either work or beg, and I'd rather work. Oh, I saw Horley. Now, he wants you to come down and meet him in Blackwater when you get a chance. I think he might have some work for you. Oh, and while you're out on your travels, you may see some folk with employment opportunities. Good folk, bad folk, looking for a tough guy with a gun to help them. Up to you if you listen to them, I guess. I used to like that kind of stuff. One time, I almost helped a clown steal an elephant. But that's a very silly story. Welcome home. Make yourself at home. It is your home.
Thank you. Who's that bad woman?
Hello, Mr. Jones.
I said, who is that? Is that a kind woman? Is that a good woman? Is that a bad woman? Is that a she-devil?
Maybe it's all of them at once. And maybe there ain't no she-devil. Maybe there ain't no kindness.
You is always a strange one, Horley. How is Mrs. LeClerc?
About as you'd expect.
I expect a lot. It's mighty bad business. LeClerc was a good man, a fine man.
That he was.
And this gal is...
Well, that's their business.
Oh, that's the world's business. The world's business is kindness and gentleness and evil and brutality. What else is there, mister?
Well, there's a whole lot else besides. Like lust and greed and stupidity.
Oh, Mr. Jones is stupid. Oh, Jones is old. Oh, Jones has cooked himself in the sun. I know, I know.
Get yourself something to eat.
There's fellas need help. Maybe this gal can help them.
Maybe. They're on the run.
That ain't my business. My business is what they do hereafter. That's my business.
Well, they certainly need money.
Yeah, there's always money. Money for them is good, and money for them is not so good. But maybe they could first go see the sheriffs and see what work is afoot. I reckon, for now at least, we might as well try. The sheriff at Blackwater, he needs help. No, not the fella that arrested you. That was the marshal. The police chief. He's a decent enough fella for all we know. Poor bastard is overrun, and he don't want old Jones.
There's a couple other sheriffs that need help. A fella from Valentine, he's at the Painted Sky Ranch. The Tumbleweed Sheriff's at the Tumbleweed Jail, and the Blackwater Sheriff, he's at Pike's Basin.
Maybe all that'll show what kind of woman this is. Go and pay them all a call. That's what I reckon.
Maybe. I guess we will see. Meet me back here after you've seen them.
Good evening, sweetheart. What?
Welcome, ma'am, welcome.
Hope your first time here is a pleasant experience.
If you get any closer, we'll be related.
Is there something I can get for you? Bye now.
My husband was just saying he thinks he saw an outlaw camp somewhere outside of town.
Things aren't what they once were.
Hello. Welcome, stranger. Grocery items aren't hard to find. Canned foods are by the door, and the fresher produce are by the stairs. Fresh meat by the counter, too.
You're welcome back if you change your mind.
Welcome. Please, take a seat. I had a gentleman in here yesterday. Had to wash my hands 4 times after he was through. Well, we'll be here if you change your mind.
Why, hello there. First time in my studio. Welcome, welcome. All right, then, let's begin. Oh, a very popular one, this. Remember, you'll need to keep still for this. Now then, let's settle on a pose for you. God's presence, truly witnessed in the Falls of Niagara. That'll work wonderfully for you. Paris, France. A city as beautiful as living poetry. The intoxicating majesty of the open prairie. A trip to the saloon with none of the riffraff, eh? I'll be here if you ever want to get a photo.
Hello, dear.
Stay away from me, you idiot.
All right, then.
I've heard. Hello.
Can I help you?
Welcome. Don't miss the latest additions to our selection. So, what do you think? Wearing it out? That's all right. Whatever you feel. I stand behind everything I sell in this place, so you can purchase with confidence. A good coat could save your life. A great coat will look good doing it. No problem at all. I only stock the best in my shop. Buy from me, and you'll never be disappointed. No problem at all. If you change your mind, it'll be here waiting for you. I have a feeling you'll be back.
I'm here if you change your mind.
Puta madre! Help, please!
Good to have you.
If it's a postal matter, speak to the other clerk.
So long.
Anything I can do for you?
Forgot to do something.
May I help you? Okay, well, you know the country around Manzanita Post? Ain't as safe as it used to be. Some nasty people up there. But I imagine that's why this wagon train wants someone to ride them through it. Can you do that? Accompany them and stop them getting bushwhacked? Okay, come along.
Wonder how many serial criminals I've let pay off their debt with cold cash. Have a good one.
Howdy, ma'am.
Staying here is a funny way of going about doing business.
Howdy there, friend.
Oh, you need some mess. When you're ready.
Mm-hmm.